Hello and welcome to Zurich Airport in Switzerland. Today I'm flying with Etihad Airways to Abu Dhabi. I've flown with them a few times in economy class. I'm excited to experience their business class product. In the future, I'll also be reviewing Emirates and Qatar Airways. So let's go and see how good Etihad is first. Zurich Airport is the main gateway to Switzerland. I travelled with Air Serbia from Belgrade the night before and arrived here at 7:55 PM. Since it was relatively late and I wanted to maximize my lounge use for my Etihad flight the next day, I stayed at the Transit Hotel. The hotel offers single, double and triple rooms, as well as couches, and can be booked for periods ranging from 3 hours to overnight, depending on your budget and transit time. Switzerland is a notably expensive country. It cost me 120 Swiss francs for an overnight stay in this single room. In addition to the bed, the room is equipped with reading lights, charging ports, a desk, a TV, a sink, and a kettle. There's no ensuite bathroom, they are shared with other guests. Nevertheless, the place is well maintained and the shower water is warm with good pressure. As an AV geek, all these inconveniences and high costs were forgiven when I opened the curtains. This is quite a unique view. The Transit Hotel is in Terminal D, and my flight to Abu Dhabi departs from Terminal E.
Next departure to Gates E, Track 1.
To get there, I had to take a short ride on the Sky Metro, a driverless automated people mover.
Come again soon. There is so much more to see. For now, I wish you a pleasant flight.
Terminal E, also known as the midfield terminal, is exclusively dedicated to non-Schengen international flights. Being a standalone terminal, it is installed with floor-to-ceiling windows on all sides of the building, providing abundant natural light and impressive views of the apron. The bench chairs don't have armrests, making them perfect for napping if you have an overnight layover and don't want to pay for a hotel room. Zurich Airport is a hub for Swiss international airlines. As such, it operates 3 lounges at Terminal E. The Swiss First Lounge is open to Star Alliance first class passengers and Horn Circle members. The Senator Lounge is designated for Star Alliance Gold members, and the Business Lounge is accessible for Star Alliance business class passengers. Alongside the Swissair lounges, there are 2 third-party lounges and an Emirates lounge. Anticipating that Etihad, not being a Star Alliance member, would direct me to either the Aspire or Prime Class lounges, I was surprised by a special arrangement Etihad made with Swiss, allowing me to use the Swiss Business Lounge instead. The Swiss Business and Senator Lounge share a common reception desk. The Senator Lounge is marginally superior. Therefore, I tried to enter using my Star Alliance Gold status. Unfortunately, I was still directed to the Business Lounge as Etihad isn't a Star Alliance airline. I have to say, even the Business Lounge is quite amazing. Upon entering, you will find a map that helps first-time visitors navigate the available facilities. While lacking a whiskey bar, there's a self-serve minibar offering a diverse selection of spirits, wines, beers, fizzy drinks, and water. Adjacent to the bar is a cold buffet station featuring fruits, cold meats, salads, cheeses, various condiments, and bread. I must note that the choices are not overly expensive. It's similar to a Qantas club in Australia. However, there's a live chef station where you can order eggs cooked to your liking. In the middle of the lounge, there are wines, chocolates, more fruits and coffee machines. Covering an area of 1,200 square meters and a capacity of 200 seats, the business lounge has many seating options, including bar stools, dining tables and couches, accommodating both business and leisure travelers. Additionally, there are a few semi-enclosed workstations, ideal for making phone calls and completing tasks before the flight. For those facing a long layover, towards the back of the lounge, there's a quiet area with day beds. I ended up picking a seat next to the window. Zurich Airport's busiest route is to London Heathrow. Consequently, there are both European and UK-type power plugs next to my seat. Impressive attention to detail. Given the limited food options, I grabbed two Swiss chocolates, which were amazing, and ordered an omelette from the live cooking station. It tasted pretty ordinary. However, my eyes were quickly drawn to the outdoor terrace. In addition to offering some fresh air, the terrace presents spectacular views of the apron, takeoffs and landings on the runways, and the Swiss Alps in the distance. Moreover, there are even binoculars for scoping out planes on the far side of the airport. Lastly, private showers are available. Despite the limited food choices, this is still one of my all-time favorite business class lounges. There's so much natural light throughout the lounge, even in the toilets. And the outdoor terrace makes the views unbeatable. For those without lounge access, Zurich Airport has established two observation decks, one at Terminal B and the other is here in Terminal E. Positioned at the western end of the terminal and in the center of Zurich Airport's three runways, this observation deck gives you a 270-degree view of the airport. There are free-to-use binoculars that provide close-up views of all airport activities, and various play areas add an element of fun for children. Zurich Airport is certainly a haven for avgeeks and plane spotters. The aircraft that will be taking me to Abu Dhabi today is a Boeing 787-9. Currently, Etihad's fleet comprises 30 787-9s, with some having first class and others with only business and economy class. Furthermore, the airline has three new aircraft with a fresh interior and cabin design on order and is expected to join the fleet soon. Boarding commenced 45 minutes before departure. This aircraft is in a two-class layout. At the front are 28 Etihad Business Studios in a 1-2-1 configuration. Based on the Zodiac platform, these business class seats are arranged in an alternating forward-rearward staggered pattern. The best seats for solo travelers are the forward-facing window seats, providing more privacy as they are closer to the window and less exposed to the aisle. In the center section, the forward-facing rows are ideal for couples traveling together, as the seats are positioned right next to one another. Each business class passenger has access to a large overhead bin. I chose seat 10K, a forward-facing seat in the second last row. Although these seats share a strikingly similar footprint with Qatar's Q suites, they lack the sliding door, making them feel less private. An Aqua di Parma amenity kit was already on my seat when I boarded, and the crew offered me a choice of water, orange juice, champagne or lemon mint juice as soon as I settled in. My seat wasn't particularly clean. There were small flies crawling on the windows, fluff above the air vent and around the control buttons. Once everyone was on board, the crew handed me a menu and a hot wet towel, which I found perfect for wiping the surfaces around my seat.
Welcome aboard the Ferry Wings flight DY74, bound to Abu Dhabi. Our flight today will take us a flight time of 5 hours and 35 minutes. Initially, we expect to climb to 37,000 feet and then finally go to an altitude of 39,000 feet.
Seats 9C and 9H are definitely the ones to avoid, as they are rear-facing and lack windows. The business class cabin is pretty full today, with around 6 empty seats towards the back. Now let's dive into the seat's features. The seat has a width of 22 inches and plenty of leg room. A blanket is placed on the footwell, and there's a small storage area below. Next to the TV, there's a small reading light, a coat hook, and an exceptionally solid and sturdy tray table. Above this table, there are two USB ports for charging small devices, a remote for controlling the TV, and an all-in-one touch-sensitive control screen. Along the edge of the table is another seat control strip, allowing one to easily control the essential functions while lying down. This screen is available in both Arabic and English. I can use it to control the electronic window shades, the massage function, the seat cushion firmness, the seat recline, the lights around me, and the Do Not Disturb button. In addition to the overhead reading light, there's a lamp next to my seat, which in my opinion adds a luxurious elegance to Etihad's business class product. Under the lamp, you can find a magazine holder, a universal power plug, and a hidden storage space where a bottle of water and headphones are placed. The plane is equipped with Wi-Fi, and there are two packages. The $2.99 text package only allows you to send text messages on social media, while the $9.99 package enables unlimited internet access for the entire flight. If you are an Etihad guest member, which is free to join, you can get the text package for free. With this package, I couldn't refresh my Instagram feed, but I successfully sent a message on Messenger. I later decided to purchase the full $9.99 plan. The speed was fast enough for me to upload Instagram stories and watch a few videos on YouTube. While attempting to connect to the internet, the crew kindly offered me a drink and some warm nuts. As the 13th best airline in the world, according to Skytrax rankings, Etihad has a massive range of beverages in business class. There are 6 choices of teas, various types of hot and iced coffee, 4 mocktails, some creamy mixes, soft drinks, juice and water. Printed on a separate piece of paper is a wine list featuring Bellini, champagne, wines from all over the world, different spirits, liquors and beers. The butterfly effect mocktail is such a beautiful drink, refreshing and fragrant without being too sweet. It's definitely one of my favorite mocktails I've had in the sky. In the meantime, the crew also took my lunch order. Etihad allows its business class passengers to dine anytime they want, but the crew do try to encourage everyone to eat soon after takeoff. The menu features some all-day snack items and full a la carte meal choices. The service was indeed on the slower side. The crew served from the front to the back. It took about an hour from taking my order to being served the entree. I was starving. Each meal comes with a seasonal salad with olive oil, balsamic vinegar, and Etihad's signature duo bread. For starters, I chose Cecina beef. Etihad partnered with Armani Casa Tableware in December 2022. The vibrant green, white and black colors truly make the dishes stand out. The new cutlery also look stunning. This Spanish-cured, paper-thin beef tastes delectable, with a slight nuttiness, melt-in-the-mouth tenderness and a hint of smoke. Accompanied with tomatoes and olives, it's a well-balanced dish. Benefiting from Etihad's partnership with Virgin Australia, I've had the chance to visit Etihad's first lounge in Abu Dhabi, even when traveling in economy. One dish I consistently enjoyed there was the beef tenderloin. So on this occasion, I decided to try it on the plane. Considering the initial cooking is done in a central kitchen on the ground, serving a perfect reheated steak in flight is not an easy feat. My steak was cooked to well done, which isn't typically how I like it, but thankfully, with the generous amount of mushroom sauce, the meat didn't taste dry at all. Furthermore, I have never had poached apples in my steak before. Surprisingly, the sweetness of the apple worked well with the sauce. To finish, I opted for the Häagen-Dazs ice cream. There were 3 flavors available: vanilla, strawberry, and chocolate. We are now already halfway through our journey. There are 2 lavatories for the 28 business class passengers, both at the front of the plane. There's no cologne or body lotion here, as everyone was already given an amenity kit. Acqua di Parma is an Italian luxury lifestyle company that produces fragrances, skincare, and other scented products. In this beautiful faux leather bag, there's cologne, hand cream, as well as sanitizing wipes, hand sanitizer, a dental kit, socks, an eye mask, and earplugs. Let's now take a look at the in-flight entertainment system. The TV screen is 18 inches in size. As an airline that flies to over 70 destinations around the globe, I was surprised to find that the system only has 2 languages. The screen displays a comprehensive list of all available beverages on board. Although I couldn't just order my drinks with a simple touch of a button, it was still nice to see what they have without having to refer to the paper menu. Regarding the movie selection, it may not be as extensive as that of Emirates, Cathay or Turkish Airlines, there are still numerous choices available. There are also TV series, live TV, music, games, podcasts, radios, weather forecasts, and a live news feed. And of course, you can check out the flight path as well. If the main screen is too far to reach, you can use the touch-sensitive remote to make your selections. In addition, you can use the remote to check out the flight path while watching a movie on the main screen. There are still 2 hours left until landing. As expected, the seat can be converted into a fully flat bed. The rear-facing seats can extend into a 75.7-inch long bed, yet my forward-facing seat is 80.5 inches long. I'm 6'1", and my toes can't reach the wall. The narrow footwell limited the space for my legs, but I still find it comfortable, and the 22-inch seat width provides ample room for my arms and shoulders. If I have to say something negative, without a sliding door, I still feel quite exposed when lying down. Despite the lack of mattress pad on this daytime flight, a luxuriously soft and warm Armani Casa Duvet is still available. I couldn't work out the brand of the headphones, but they did an excellent job of filtering out the aircraft noise. I had an uninterrupted 1 hour nap. For those starting or concluding their journey in Abu Dhabi, all first class, the residents, and certain eligible fare class business class passengers can enjoy a complimentary chauffeur service to and from the airport. If your fare qualifies, the booking option will appear on the app, and the chauffeur can transport you to any location within the UAE. In general, it was a pleasant flight. Other than the slightly dirty seat I discovered at boarding, I was thoroughly satisfied with everything else. I love all the fancy touchscreens. The crew were nice and friendly, and I enjoyed all the dishes that I ordered. They were healthy, tasty, and the portions were generous. The seats are less private than Qatar's Q-Suite, but they are way better than the 232 layout found on the Emirates Boeing 777s. I would certainly fly with Etihad again. In fact, tomorrow I'll be flying on their A350-1000 aircraft, which features their current newest business class product, complete with individual sliding doors for enhanced privacy. I'll tell you all about that experience in my next video.
Good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Abu Dhabi. The local time here is 6:55 in the evening.
This video was filmed in June, when Etihad still operated from the old Terminal 3 instead of the midfield Terminal A at Abu Dhabi Airport. My plane was parked at a remote gate. Business class passengers were provided with a dedicated shuttle bus to the arrivals hall.
Thank you.
Welcome to Abu Dhabi. Once through immigration, the Etihad Arrivals Lounge was just before the exit. It offered several beverages, snacks, and private shower suites. For those who had arranged a chauffeur service, when you are ready to leave, the staff would accompany you to your vehicle, ensuring a seamless transition to your next destination.
Thank you. You're
welcome. It truly adds a delightful touch to the conclusion of the Etihad business class journey. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video interesting, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more flight and train reviews. See you all in my next video.